Hello and welcome to Westeros Whinging. This is episode 6. I don't have enough hands to make a fucking a V and then an I, but maybe we could, yeah, that
is the other way. Isn't this 4?
Well, from my angle, it's right, but okay. So there we go.
We're not doing this every episode, I promise you.
Okay, when we have to start doing like X's and L's, like maybe we have an issue, but maybe we should like bring on some more talent to like get some like hand models.
No. We didn't do that for the Moral Limits logo way back when, and we're not doing it now.
Now, let's start this episode with talking about Robert Baratheon's real wife, Ned fucking Stark. This episode opens up, like, very well from the last episode, right? Mm-hmm. Ned looks like he is in such bad fucking shape, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Like... it really does look like a guy who's going to suffer some, like, some infection or, like, not a good angle for him. But...
yeah, throughout the entire scene, he just looks like he's about to fucking drop dead.
Yeah.
It's the weakest we've ever seen him.
But this scene really, like, it continues what we've already been seeing, right? Mm-hmm. We see Robert Baratheon, like, stuck between the Lannisters, who he is in debt to. Mm-hmm. You know, the Ned Stark he actually cares about. You know what I mean? So, like, in this moment, you could tell, like, yeah, if Robert, like, could, he'd be like, fuck Jaime, fuck the Lannisters, but he can't. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The fact that, like, Ned Stark is taking credit for the kidnapping of Tyrion, right?
Yes.
And Robert doesn't smack the shit out of Ned, you know what I mean? But he does smack Cersei, like...
yeah. Well, it's not just that, though. I get the feeling that Robert definitely knows that he's full of shit. Like, he knows that that's not what Ned wanted. That Ned's
right,
just
no,
doing
no.
it for...
reclaiming, the, that's... yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
No,
he's doing that for his wife. He's not doing that because he genuinely did it.
But the point is, like, you can definitely tell where his rage is directed to. You know what I mean? And where his, like, actual care is directed to. You almost have a character who is just, like... I would say, like, the only one he actually gives a shit about is Ned, right?
Yeah.
With your leave, I will return to Winterfell and set matters straight.
Piss on that. Send a raven. I want you to stay. I'm the king. I get what I want.
I never loved my brothers.
Sad thing for a man to admit, but it's true. You were the brother I chose.
Yeah,
because, like, it's not Cersei, we know that. We've
no,
been knew that.
Definitely not.
It's not Joffrey. They don't really go into it in the show, but in the book, at least. Do you know why the Hound follows Joffrey around?
Why?
It's to protect Joffrey from Robert.
Oh my god!
Well, okay, so... what would you do, Jesus, if your son found a pregnant cat, cut it open, and then murdered the, like, unborn?
Okay, look.
Yeah, that's
look,
Joffrey. That's
look,
what Joffrey did.
Chill, okay? Look, I'm taking a child therapy class this semester. Whenever there's something fucked up about a kid, that's not indicative of the kid. That's on them.
That, true!
The correct answer is not to beat the shit out of them. The correct answer is to fucking... hey, maybe let's not do that.
Okay, that's an even-headed, responsible, like, genuine good faith response. But, like, in the world of Game of Thrones, if your kid brings you a dead cat that had just fucking murdered and
oh
mutilated, like, yeah, it's totally fucking Westeros to fucking beat the shit out of Joffrey, you know what I mean?
It's very Robert at the very least.
Okay,
man's a
Robert,
fucking
but
monster
Robert is
sometimes.
Not like the exception to Westeros. I feel like he's more of like
I don't think he's the exception, but he's also no better.
No,
you know?
No, he's not better. But I feel like Robert, because like we're not gonna see every man in Westeros, right? But I feel like Robert is a pretty good like example of like fucking toxic masculinity in Westeros. You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I think. Men like Robert and he's from the Wall. Is it Thorne?
Yeah.
Yeah. They're like the average man. They're
right,
like rough, tough, beat the shit out
right,
of.
Right, and that's the point. That's why. So when we hear about Sam's dad, right?
Yeah.
We could almost think of like Robert. You know what I mean? That's what I mean, right? So we have characters that we'll talk about like their fathers, and we might never see them, but we do.
Yeah.
But until then, we can sort of like imagine a Robert stand-in. You know what I mean?
Oh my god, that opens up so much about Robert. Because like, we see Robert as a cruel and like violent man in his like family life. But we don't really see, because the thing about Cersei, we can understand why Cersei is the way that she is, both because of like her family growing up and also because of her relationship with Robert, right? But we don't get to see why Joffrey is who he is, because that's not like he woke up one day and he was a fucking like wants to stab kitties. Like, no, this kid's fucking a product of an abusive fucking household.
Yeah, that's the thing is, when we look at Joffrey, we gotta look at it more of, this is not some, like, sociopath who, like, just goes into Sansa's room to, like, play for emotions because that's how he was born. You kinda gotta look at, like, who both of his parents are and who is, like, one, sending him there and who has taught him to have such, like, no compassion, no empathy, you know what I mean? It's such a product of this world.
Yeah, and it's kind of like, what's kind of interesting about him is that, we, as far as we know him, like, he's kind of like a worse version of both of them.
Yeah.
In a lot of ways. Like, Cersei is, like, just as, like, anti-everyone but what I care about.
Yeah.
But she's a lot more cunning. Joffrey's too young to be cunning, so he's just very blatant about it. That's why he ignores Sansa for so fucking long. Like, weeks on end, he's just fucking, like, ghosting that bitch.
But, like, fuck Robert and his fucking honoring of women.
See what she does to me? My loving wife. I should not have hit her. That was not kingly.
Now, speaking of Robs in this show,
I
was shocked to hell because I was like, I was joking with you in between these podcasts, like, god damn it, is Robb Stark fucking useless in season one?
He's just, he kind of doesn't do anything on his own for a very long time.
Yeah.
This is, I think, the first example of, like, we really get to see a fleshed out Robb Stark. This episode introduced us to a lot of really cool things about him. One, is something that's, like, true of most of the Starks, if not all of them, is his, like, genuine love of his family, right? So there's this moment where Theon, for all intents and purposes, makes the best decision possible, which is shoot the guy that has a knife to your brother's throat. But the first thing that Robb does when he gets a hold of his brother is like, oh my god, what if you had missed Theon? My brother would be dead. And it's like, yeah, but like, what option does he have in that situation? This kid's literally at fucking knife point. He has a clear shot. He's a good fucking archer. We know that Theon, as much as you meaned about him last episode, he actually is a good archer.
Are you all right?
Yes. It doesn't hurt.
Tough little lad. In the Iron Islands, you're not a man until you've killed your first enemy. Well done.
Have you lost your mind? What if you'd missed?
He would have killed you and cut Bran's throat.
You don't have the right
to... To what? To save your brother's life? It was the only thing to do, so I did it.
What about her?
Give me my life, my lord, and I'm yours.
We'll keep her alive.
It was kind of interesting seeing Theon, like, actually be good at it. You know what I mean?
Because
it kind of shows, like, maybe when he's, like, practicing and shit, like, and he's being shit on by Luwin, maybe he is off his game. But when it comes to, like, when it matters most, like, he is a good shot. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And one thing that's kind of interesting, it's kind of like dialogue reveals character in this moment, is that, like, and this has been something that's been a staple of Theon for the rest of these episodes, but there's this really great line where he says, you're not a real man on the Iron Isles until you, you know, kill your first man. Mm. And, like, what the fuck are you talking about, my dude? You have never been on the Iron Isles for more than, like, 5 years of your life. You spend all of your time in the north. Don't fucking lie to me. You don't know what it's like to be there.
But it's
but he like pretends to retain that, yeah. You know? Everything that he knows is probably through, like, the books about, like, what are they about? Like,
it's such an interesting exploration of a character who is not from, like he's not, he has no, like, actual memory connection of where he's from, mm-hmm. but he is so bound by, like, heritage and, like, nationality, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah. There's, like, this, you must feel, like, connected to your house, because that's the way it is in this world. Everyone is meant to, you know, you have to have pride in your house, yeah. No matter what.
It's like that political compass test question, where it's just, like, should you be proud of, like, where you were born? Should you be proud of where you're from? And, like, that is Theon.
Yes.
And that's the natural extension of answering, yes, you should be proud of where you're from. Yeah,
yeah, I mean, exactly. And the reality of Theon. Dumb fuck
Theon.
Dude, there are a lot of really, like, small things I really love about the way that Theon and Rob kind of interact with each other. And I really appreciate that, like, Rob is a lot more reserved than Theon is. And they kind of, like, Theon is almost like a bad influence in some of these scenes. Like, when he's talking about how, oh, you know, they've already, like, tried to kill your father. You need to be, like, you need to get out there. But here's the thing about it. Everyone can see the writing on the wall except for Rob. He's almost too reserved. He's almost like, no, war is bad. I don't want to go to war. I'm not the real, I don't feel like the king in the north yet. You know, only my father can make that decision.
Yeah.
But everyone, even Ross, can see.
It's coming.
It's wartime. Yeah. Like, this bitch is fucking going to war. There's nothing that anyone can do to stop it at this point.
Yeah.
They have drawn blood from the king, or not the king of the north, the Warden of the North. Yeah. That's, like, a big fucking deal. It's in a Stark, no less.
Yeah.
Rob needs to go to war, if for no other reason than to save some face in the eyes of, like, the rest of his bannermen.
Well, yeah, because, like, okay, if you're too weak around Westeros, like, other houses will do shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you got the Boltons, you got the fucking Vale, like, they're off their fucking rocker.
Oh,
which we'll get to in 1 minute. But I just, that's, like, that's sort of what I meant last week when talking about, like, Dorne, right? It's not like I have anything against Dorne. It's just, like, I know for a fact, because of their bad history with the Baratheons, like, they will jump at an excuse to, like, fuck up Robert. You know what I mean?
Yeah. That's kind of the thing that,
And the Iron Islands. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, they're a great example. I'm
telling you. It's been 9 years since they fucking last rebelled. It's like, time.
They're itching for that fucking rebellion.
Theon's got that rebellion in his balls just going, like, come on.
And now that he doesn't have Ross to dump it in.
Yeah. You're not a true man in the Iron Islands until you've rebelled.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. One neat thing that, now that we're on the topic of it, though, I really do love Ross. She's, like, a really great kind of, like, background character that we see that, like, she's so much smarter than, we knew this from episode one, than everyone else around her. She's, like, she's very cunning.
Yeah.
She knows where the money is. She knows where she needs to go. And I really love watching her kind of, like...
It's good business, right?
Yeah.
You're still here. It's over. Go home. Oh, you're expecting a teaser for
like Twitch and see how well the audio is.
He's not. Do you want it to be?
No.
Oh my god. It's not off.
What's not off?
The square over your face, genius. You're in focus. That's great, but check the audio. Check the audio. That's some good volume we're getting right there.
Do you actually see the square in the...
Yes. Yeah, look. That's the thing that I need.
Stuart, help. I mean, Chase. Oh.
Wait.
Oh, shit.
Jesus, I need you to not do that, because once I lock in your focus, it's on manual, so it no longer audio focuses. So... Stay still.
He has such a serious face on him. How can you take that shit seriously? Look at him. Hey!
You're asking Jesus to stay still and not make noise on camera? I think he is very receptive to that idea.
You're right. This is the all quiet podcast. That's what this is.
The low energy podcast where Stuart fixes his hair.
Where are you? I swear to God, Twitch so much hates you that it doesn't want to show me where you are, even though you're clicking. Someone I'm following.
Just be sitting at the iron farm.
As long as it's not going through the TV where it goes. Much appreciated.
That's not us. Why? Why is the? Oh, here we go. You listen to that.
Stuart, you're fucking coughing.
Oh wait.
What is with that sound you just made?
What?
Why the...
Oh, that's the golems make when they're dying.
Why? Is that what he's doing?
Yeah, because look.
Alright, let me talk from right here. Westeros Whinging, episode 7. If it's not episode 7, I blame Jesus.
It is episode 7. Stop being an idiot.
See?
I'm bopping. Wait, do it again. We're bopping.
Okay.
Why did you just close my phone?
Alright, I think we're good on audio. Let me just adjust the light.
Let me double check.
Do it again.
We're good.
You hit it. You hit the yellow. Not as.
Where's the water? No, it's so far.
No, no refills on this podcast. We don't do that shit.
I'm empty.
We just started.
Give me yours.
You want my hair water?
No. Wait, ew. Anna Maria, give me water.
Oh my God. I could have done this from the beginning. Where, dude, look at that.
Nice.
Yeah, put it on my head.
No! You have to
put it on my head.
Where's your pomade?
We're live. No. Stuart, that's a bad idea.
I don't think so. I think it worked. Oh my fucking God, it worked.
There's one in
and
the back.
It's on camera.
There's one in the back.
I'm gonna put you on the back. Alright?
Okay.
Here, Stuart, here's a beanie.
Look. That remark of putting you on the back and I would be taken very sexually or racially.
Or it could be taken as neither. If you want it to be. I'll wear the beanie today.
Oh my God. I would have worn my beanie.
Oh, but I look like an egg now. Give me your glasses. Let me try that now.
You know who you look like, Jesus?
Who?
Jughead.
No! All right.
We're out. You look weird.
Stuart.
It's weird.
It's weird, dude. All right, I take
that joke's for Banane.
Yeah. Make sure to put it. Oh, wait, is the audio on? Hello?
Oh, shit. Popcorn's falling everywhere. Where's the trash can? Did you not bring it back in?
It's right there. Next to the water.
What are you doing with that fucking egg?
It's going to be a part of the podcast. It's a prop.
Yeah,
well, Anna Maria, we can't start until you're ready for us to start, and then we can turn the air back on. So it's entirely
that's
up
fine.
To you.
I got the blanket. I'm not hot anymore.
Okay. So we'll just chill until the episode starts. Maybe drink a little hair water.
Ew. I don't know what's worse, hair water or cold or warm water.
Warm water, objectively.
That's your water from last time. You didn't fucking finish it.
Moral limits.
That's true.
Jesus. Moral limits just rambling right now.
All
right. Warm water. Why is warm water bad, Jesus?
Why is it not bad? It's the worst thing ever.
Absolutely. See, I feel like...
it's in my foot! Sorry.
Warm water. The warm water?
There's two of us.
They multiply. Wait, give me a peanut. Stuart needs one, too. Stuart, you know what must be done.
Dude, your hair's going back up.
I don't believe you.
As you put it down.
See, I feel like warm water goes back to, like, man's most primal form of being disgusted with lake water. Because lake water is just, like, you know what I mean?
I well, lake water can be cold.
Well, if it's downstream from a fucking, you know, ice cap. But
or like, if it's winter.
What about desert water?
Dumbass. Okay, well, desert water is disgusting. Well, there has to be. Otherwise, the desert wouldn't exist.
Desert's a desert because it has the water.
But then what about cactus?
That's inside the cactus.
Well, no, but they get water from somewhere. Or they die.
That is not good.
What do you mean that's not good?
Bang for the mic.
Oh. Bang.
Stuart, this would go a lot faster if you helped me. Just take it out.
I put myself in focus to start the podcast. We're now stuck here, or I have to restart the entire camera process and take another 20 minutes.
Okay. Or you could just wait for me for another 30. So I could finally take out all these peanuts out of this box.
Why don't you just dump them?
With this tiny hand.
Alright, what can we talk about for 30 minutes while she works?
I say we litigate the CGI discussion from Twitter.
What? But I hate CGI. CGI is ugly.
Let's see. Let's pull up exact quotes as to not misrepresent the
arguments.
The opposing counsel.
Stuart, look at all these peanuts.
Look at all
the chickens. I saw that meme for the first time with Manani the other day. She showed
that
it to me.
That meme is years old. Years.
I'm out of touch with the memes, okay?
Stuart didn't know about it either, dude.
So wait, what is your plan? You see your rice cooker and
then...
I'd
be happy and then you guys can thump all you guys want. If I'm strong enough.
I have horns.
Cuernos.
Stuart... Can you see both of them or only one?
You can see. Honestly, they're more like cat ears.
They're not like cat ears. Wait, that's the wrong one. That's the one you can see.
You can see the other one. Wait, there's also one in the center?
No.
Yeah?
No. Stop. What the fuck are you doing?
Searching for the lost.
And there's no lost peanut.
Well, there's a lost Jughead beanie that you're not wearing anymore.
Oh, yeah, because it's over there now. He ruined the joke. I would have worn it for the podcast. Made your life easier in the editing process.
I'll just CG on it. Jughead it for you.
Okay. Ow. I could have done this the entire morning. I chose to do it right before you guys start filming.
Technically, you started doing it right when we did start filming, not before.
Wait, hold up. The Twitch thumbnail right now?
Yes, 100 times.
That's
yes.
Your new contact photo. What the fuck? Where do I get the fucking 12 viewers from?
I don't 12 years?
Viewers.
What?
Not now.
Oh.
Me playing fucking Call of Duty last night.
Oh. Cool. I might actually throw up if I drink any more of this fucking water.
Well, and you fucked up the camera.
How?
The box. Bumped it.
The water, Stuart. The water.
Let me just put it further away
from you. No! Come back. I need the water. Let's mix the warm water in with the cold one to make it cold. It's not that much. There's enough ice. It'll work.
Dude, this is so beautiful.
Don't put it on top of machines.
That is my tablet. Are you gonna buy me a new one?
Right, I know. Off. Cold
take,
water.
Take it off the desk.
After I get my refill. No.
See, now I want to drink water.
That made me
thirsty.
Water ASMR. Purification, purification, purification.
Oh, shit. Wait, have you even gotten that far?
No! I've seen, like, a grand total of, like, 3.5 episodes. As of most anime, Alex shows me.
Alright, get the fuck out of here.
Changes so frequently.
Who, Alex?
Yeah.
Wait, what about it? Seasonal.
Well, I don't, because we only go every once in a while.
You only go every once in a while. He invites you every single time. Oh!
<I'm an asshole. laughs> What happened?
And keep Alex slander to the minimum. He watches.
I just said I'm... Well, that's my fault. I don't like being social.
And that's where Alex on the other end of the computer goes, mm-hmm. Alright, Jesus, slow down. I swear to God, if that ice cream truck does not move.
Do I want some ice cream?
Same.
Look at the face.
It's an ice cream podcast.
Okay, Jesus. Stay in position.
Give me the beanie. I actually don't like my hair today. So it's over there somewhere.
Jesus is so... Jesus fucking put it mute.
I did not.
And you were doing your fucking your water shit. Something.
It's on top of this mic. How?
Wait, is it over here?
Yes.
Yeah. How right would I have it?
Oh, like. Yeah. Sort of like. Would have. brush. And it's all taped, too. Yeah, because it's on tape. He knows he did. I still feel like...
I didn't even mean to.